match about to get underway here, fans. These two guys you're about to see used to be friends, used to be partners, along with the whole Quickie Mart crew. But right now they've got zero use for each other. And out first, as Gangrel this week, it's Mark Zout.
Mark Zout, the king of gimmick infringement. You think Gangrel, the vampire warrior David Heath, would be at home right now upset with Mark Zout for stealing his gimmick? But the truth is, Mark Zout's far more over, and he's making a hell of a lot more money in IPW, wrestling as a different character each week than Gangrel is on the independent scene.
All right, what are these two guys doing coming out here, Nimi?
I have no idea whatsoever. You want to talk about hanger-ons? You want to talk about lackeys? We call that manager right there the trailer park trash. He claims to be some type of pimp. What kind of pimp dresses like that, Aaron?
Obviously a pimp who's not doing very well. And I tell you, he brings DR to the ring with him. We've seen DR in and out of IPW a couple of times, but we've never seen him coming out here cutting a promo like this. And they have nothing to do with this match.
Star Stevens looks on wondering what the hell these two individuals are doing in an IPW hardcore wrestling ring, especially at the Florida WrestlePlex.
And then you see Concession Boy just caught in your screen there. Obviously these guys must have something set up with Concession Boy. And here, right from behind on Mark Zout. I guess that's a way to take advantage early on.
Concession Boy has put on a huge amount of bulk and size. Just when we got people like the Bug whipping himself into shape, we got Concession Boy trying to get to a lean, mean 300 pounds. And what the hell happened to his mask? Do these guys think that they can book their own angles in IPW?
Well, I try to.
I know you do, and I think they're trying to take a page out of Aaron Royal's book. Concession Boy, obviously putting on a lot of size, putting on a lot of strength. He's one of the strongest individuals, believe it or not, in the IPW dressing room. Like I said before, it's somewhat like retard-like strength.
Okay, maybe he'll become a part of Short Bus very soon, who knows. Right now, though, besides the strength, Concession Boy improving by leaps and bounds in the ring. Right now, though, him and Mark Zout having a test of strength, and Mark Zout holding his own does a reversal, and that'll take care of the strength every time if you actually wrestle.
You talk about the technical superiority in IPW hardcore wrestling. Concession Boy, who usually is working the IPW concession stand, selling those IPW exclusive bratwursts, he comes in, Mark Zout trading hammerlock for hammerlock, there's a test of strength, and now he's ramming his head into the turnbuckle. These guys can wrestle, they can mix it up, and there you go, Concession Boy turns the tables on Mark Zout and smashes his head into the turnbuckle.
I tell you what, no love lost between these two, as we said. These two, not like a traditional tag team that broke up that knows each person's every move, but at the same time, these guys definitely are very familiar with each other, and right now, Concession Boy's going, you might have used to be my friend, but right now, I'm hitting you in the head with my forearm.
You want to talk about stiff? We're always talking about the stiff wrestlers in IPW. Concession Boy, he does it perfectly legal. He's not going to crush his head with his knuckles. He's going to smash him with some vicious forearms and elbows to the head, and Mark Zout is in trouble.
Mark Zout whipped into the corner, elbow right across the head by Concession Boy. Okay, well, Mark Zout started out fast and furious in this match, but Concession Boy using the strength to his advantage right now, firmly in control of this match. And what's he got going on here? Oh, he's dropping him. Powerbomb. This could be it for Mark Zout. One, two. No, it looks like Concession Boy just let him go.
Not the prettiest powerbomb ever seen here in IPW, but effective nonetheless. And Concession Boy on the second rope with a huge fist drop, Jerry the King Lawler style, and nobody's home.
Nobody home. I guess he didn't have Mark Zout quite as out of it as he thought. And here comes Mark Zout back, and the fans are going nuts. Mark Zout, a big fan favorite here in IPW.
We just had a huge show here at the WrestlePlex. We had a fan appreciation night. Tickets were only $5. But next week, June 28th at the Florida WrestlePlex, we have Loki. We have Christopher Daniels. We have the NWA Florida heavyweight champion, Danny Doring, facing off against Mike Sullivan. And yes, you will see Mark Zout and a Concession Boy. I have no idea if he'll have his mask on next week, Aaron.
Well, I tell you, Concession Boy, you never know what he's going to do from week to week, whether he's going to be in the concession or wrestling, whether he's going to wear the mask or not. All I know is that each and every time you meet up with Concession Boy, you wonder, is this guy crazy?
He is crazy, and the pain he could take, he wants to go through tables on fire. He wants to be brain-bustered into a pile of tacks. But right there, he takes a huge DDT-like maneuver from the top rope. One, two, three, your winner, Mark Zout.
All right, Mark Zout on a roll here in IPW. Fans, we're going to be back in just a few minutes with more weekly recap on UPN 44.